Hey guys, as you can see, today is a little bit of a different video. I wanted to experiment with how I make my videos and what kind of style they are and how I film them. So yeah, I want to show a little bit more of my day, of my comic process. And yeah, that's just what I'm going to try out in this video, and I hope you like this. So, before I'm going to show you how I'm currently working on my comic, I wanted to show you a little bit more about how I started and how I got to where I am right now. So I've gathered a lot of stuff that is related to the comic that I'm working on right now. And this isn't even everything yet, but I just wanted to show you how much I've already done before I'm actually starting on it. So this is the very, very first piece that I'm going to show you guys. And it was actually done back in January 2018. And as you can see, it's very, very different from how I am working right now. But this piece was a concept work that I did for a story about a young witch that was learning how to do magic. So basically, the concept is the same. I've let that idea rest for a while. I started working on my portfolio to get accepted into art school, and I've done a ton of other things. But when I was already in art school, this is November 2018, I did this little sketch in my sketchbook, and this is actually what started the whole idea for my comic that's called Witch's Brew. And everything for that comic idea is worked off of this tiny sketch. As you can see, an idea can spark from every little drawing that you do in your sketchbook. This was a concept art that I did for Witch's Brew. And in this sketchbook, I worked a lot on Witch's Brew. I'm not going to show everything because that would be too much. Let's see. And while I was working on Witch's Brew, I noticed that that story was way too big and way too difficult for me to start out on. So I started developing a different story, which is now my comic that's now called Not a Witch. So these were some first pieces that I tried to do, traditional in watercolors. Actually, this one I finished digital. And in this sketchbook, I did a lot of world building and a lot of concept art. As you can see, this is Rudy, my main character. I was developing him here a bit more. And here you can see little sketches for pages that I was thumbnailing to try some stuff out. Some of you may recognize this as one of my newer sketchbooks. There's also a lot of style exploration and environment design for the comic. And here we have another style test that I did in watercolors. So the plan was to do this in watercolors and then finish it digital. I'll show you the finished piece of this page on the screen right now. And here are the other ones. They actually never finished digital. Another watercolor piece test and a character design that I did for one of the teachers. So this is all of the old stuff that I'm not currently working on anymore. Let me get this out of the way. And now I'm going to show you some more recent stuff. I also have a lot of notes and just writing for the comic, by the way, but I'm not going to show everything here. There's a little piece of writing. Let's see. There's an old storyboard I was working on. And, here I have more storyboarding. So a lot of just developing the story here. I did most of the world building in my sketchbooks. And now I'm really going to figure everything out. Here I'm working on character sheets. And this is a pretty new sketchbook. But here I am just trying some things out. Here on the other page, I hope you guys can see it, but here are some little thumbnails and little IDs for the comic. And here are some sketched out panels that actually ended up in the comic. Hey guys, for this part of the video I'm working in a voiceover format because I didn't think it would be really interesting to watch me do this part in real time. As I've been saying, I want to try a little bit of a different format, and I really want to show you guys my process of making a webtoon, and I want to show as much as I can. I wanted to say everything, but I know I'm always going to do parts off camera when I don't have my camera with me or when new things pop into my mind and I'm not able to film it. So yeah, I want to show as much as I can. And making a webtoon, it's not only drawing, it's also a lot of thinking, a lot of planning. And as you can see me doing here, I had a general idea of where I wanted the story to go and how I wanted it to start, but I didn't exactly know what was going to happen, so I just made a mind map to explore all the possible ideas. And yeah, that takes a lot of time, but I wanted to show it. So you can see it's really just a messy process. And don't try to make everything nice and clean, just work in the way that works for you. This messy process is also what I'm going to use to write a script later on in this video. I don't usually use scripts, but I will explain you more about it later on. But first, I have something exciting to show you guys, I think. So now you've seen a ton of work that I did in my sketchbooks and a ton of world building that I did before. And last week I actually finished the first episode of the comic. It's not been published yet on Webtoon, and I still need to make a logo and like a credits part and stuff. But I'm going to show you guys this as a sort of teaser. So I'm not going to talk, not going to say what's going on. I'm just going to scroll and you can read it for yourself if you want to. Yeah, so now you guys have seen probably 80%. No, I don't think you've seen 80%, maybe less. Maybe 60% of what I've done for the comics until now. And in this video series, I want to show you more of my process and more of what I'm doing. And hopefully it'll give you some insight in how I made a comic. And hopefully it will also give you some motivation to see where I've come from and see where I am now. And maybe it will inspire you to work on your own comic. Hey guys, it's evening right now. I'm sorry if there's a little bit background noise, but I just wanted to say that I've done some thinking where I want to go with this part of the story, and I think I'm ready to do some writing. I'll speed this writing up too, so you don't have to watch me write real time. And then later on in the video, I hope to finish up with some drawing. So if you're looking forward to it, keep looking at the video. I don't have a lot of experience in script writing. I'm not really good at it. I should probably use a pencil so I can erase. The only thing to get better in things is to practice them, I guess. And I've read some theory. And now I just gotta put that theory to use, I guess. So many artists have probably advised you to write a script if you're going to make a webcomic. And while I also think it's really useful, I also don't always use it. And I kind of wanted to explain you why. I'm a person that has a very, very hard time seeing things in my head while I write them down in words. It's so much easier for me to think out in thumbnails than it is in words. And that's why I don't always use a script. But one thing that's really, really important, and that's really is something that a script helps you with, is keeping the personalities of your characters consistent. Sometimes when I'm jumping from panel to panel and I haven't planned out what my characters are going to say, they sometimes act out of character because I am not planning it in advance. And when I'm first making a script, it's much easier to read it back and change things and change how the characters are acting and make them act more like their personalities. And that's something that a script really helps you with. And of course, if you sit down to thumbnail and you already know what is going to happen and what the characters are going to say, it's so much easier to come up with different thumbnails of how the comic is going to look like. So yeah, that's why I think a script is also something that could be really important, but you just have to find something that works for you. If you can work perfectly fine without a script, then that's fine. But if a script helps you to write your comic, then you should certainly do it. Just try it out. And if it doesn't work the first time, try it out a couple of more times. And if it still doesn't work, then just don't do it. You can see me making small doodles in this script. That's what I said. I can't really think in words. I can't convey emotions in words, especially not in English, because it's not my main language. And that's why I also in my scripts put small drawings. That just makes it a little bit easier for me to just really feel the emotion of the character. So we've jumped into the thumbnailing part of this video, and I must say that I think thumbnailing is my favorite part. And
I can do it forever and ever, and I can explore all the different views and angles that my panels can be. But the fact is that you don't want to spend too much time on this stage. You just want to try out a couple of options for each panel. And for this first panel, I actually think I spent a little bit too much of time, but because it's the establishing shot of my comic, I spent, what did I do, like 5-6 thumbnails until I finally stumbled upon one that I really liked. So yeah, this part is really important. I think you should never ever skip the thumbnailing part, because if you skip it, then you will just make the panels that are the first ones that come into your mind, and I think your comic will look really generic and really boring if you do this. And thumbnails aren't meant to be pretty, they're just meant for you to figure out the composition, to figure out the general picture, what's going on in the panel, and if you can understand what's going on, then really it's good enough. So as me showing this to you guys, I really hope that you can take something out of this, because most of these pictures that I'm drawing here, they will probably not make a lot of sense to you. I really like my thumbnailing part in pen. I almost never do these in pencil unless I only have a pencil within reach. Then I usually use a pencil. But I try to do these in pen, and if a thumbnail just doesn't work out, I'll just scrap it and move on to the next thumbnail. Because the thing is that if you work in pencil on this stage, you really... If you also use an eraser, then it's really easy to just make one thumbnail and keep fixing that. And I think you just want to get all your mistakes out of there and leave them there on the page for you to see. Some creators like to thumbnail actually the whole comic before they start drawing, or at least the whole chapter or the whole episode. I don't really do that. I usually work in batches of like 10 panels. This is a really fun process, but for me it's also quite draining. It's a process where I really have to think. So that's why I like to switch up in between thumbnailing and doing stuff like working out the sketches. That's a lot easier on the mind, I think. Now a little bit more about this new film ID that I'm doing. So I want to show more of these kinds of videos where you can see me working, and that will also lead to a lot of things that will repeat, since this thumbnailing part is something that I have to do a lot. I'll show it in more videos. I just wanted to know if that's okay with you guys, and if you guys like that, or if that's a bit boring to you guys. Definitely let me know. My time to talk is up. I upload every Wednesday. If you could leave a like and a comment, that would be great. If you could subscribe, that would be also great. And I really hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye!